Another important word to know here is complementary, which means that we can easily predict which bases are on the strand if we already know the ones on the opposite strand in the same location. So for example, if here we have thymine as a nitrogen space, we already automatically know that adenine is on the opposite strand. If it's guanine, then on the opposite strand we have cytosine. And if you can notice, it's always a pyrimidine base binding to a purine base. Two rings binding with one ring.
But let's say if you're watching this video 15 minutes before a class starts. Don't worry, you can still do something about it. You can do the scan reading, in which you can scan to find and read the headings and subheadings of the material that should be covered during the class. And pay special attention to bolded sentences and presented figures, because it is likely that the teachers or professors will dedicate the most time on those, and they will most probably ask them during revisions or in the test.
A less known fact is that we can also create oncolytic virus, which can target and infect and kill cancer cells.
Kill cancer cells.
The steps to create GMOs are: first, we have to identify the gene responsible for the desired characteristic. Then we copy that gene and insert it into another organism, which then becomes GMO. And we allow it to grow in suitable conditions. And we get a plant frog.
I'm kidding, the result is much less dramatic than that. Then I was invited to a symposium for celebrating women leaders, and I was truly amazed. I started seeing myself as someone who can inspire, lead, and motivate others. I founded a club at my university supporting women in STEM, and I managed to graduate as the highest achieving graduate. Now I'm making YouTube videos to give a female voice in the science topics. But let's focus on the living organisms in this video.
Both cell types share some similar features, such as they have a cytoplasm which fills up the cell. They have a DNA, ribosomes, which are the structures responsible for protein synthesis. And both cell types are surrounded by a cell membrane. The histone proteins that pack the DNA molecule into chromosomes in eukaryotes can undergo some chemical modifications that result in making the DNA more loose or more compact. This modulates the gene expression, more particularly the transcription of DNA into RNA. There are other proteins called transcription factors that directly bind to the DNA molecule, thus controlling the rate of gene transcription into RNA. Some enzymes can also regulate the gene expression through their involvement in the chemical modifications of the DNA, RNA, or the produced protein. MicroRNA is a short RNA molecule that can hinder the gene expression by specifically binding to the RNA transcript. The CRISPR-associated protein Cas9, whose gene is adjacent to the CRISPR locus, associates with the guide RNA, which guides it to the target site of the viral genome, that is complementary to the guide RNA sequence, which separates the strands. Then both strands of the viral genome are cut with the help of the enzyme activity of Cas9 protein, and this typically disables the virus. The nucleotide excision is similar, with the difference being that the entire nucleotide gets removed and replaced with the correct one. So not only the nitrogenous base, but also one sugar and phosphate get removed and replaced.
A very important thing is also to label everything. Samples, glassware, label everything that you're using. It can save you time trying to figure out which one was which. We're all human, we forget, and that's okay, that's why we have markers.
So to actually get the protein sequence from this RNA transcript, you'll have to memorize this table.